they saw transportation in human beings. What was the transportation? The blood from the heart was carried to the lungs for purification. The pure blood from the lungs was carried again back to the heart. What happens here is the impure blood or the deoxygenated blood from other parts of the body gets collected into the heart. From the heart, it is taken to the lungs. In the lungs, the blood is purified, and the pure blood again enters into the heart, and from the heart it is distributed to the other parts of the body, so it can reach to each and every cells of the body. Same way, transportation in plants is also essential. So today we are going to see regarding the transportation in plant. Now we saw that during photosynthesis, carbon dioxide and the energy, which was the energy? The sun energy. Both are stored in chlorophyll. Okay. Carbon dioxide is a raw material which is essential for preparing the food. And it is the raw material. Without this raw material, the plant cannot prepare its food. Along with this raw material, certain other raw materials are also needed by the plants. The other raw materials are nitrogen, phosphorus, and other minerals. These are also the raw materials. So they are also the raw materials. These raw materials are very important for the plant because it requires for building plant bodies. So only carbon dioxide is not enough. So these raw materials should be given to the plants so that they can build up their plant bodies. So from where these raw materials should be provided into the plants? That is, these raw materials are found in the soil in the form of salts. And in the soil, minerals also there. So from the soil, so these raw materials, where are they found? They are found in the soil. So from the soil, these raw materials should be carried to the chlorophyll. So wait, from the soil, these raw materials should pass to chlorophyll. So imagine that the raw material in the soil. Soil means which part of the plant will help? The roots are in the soil. So the roots will absorb this whatever the raw materials is there from the soil, and from there it should reach the chlorophyll. So you can say that the distance from soil to whatever it has chlorophyll is more. If the plant is short, the distance may be less, but if the plant is tall, the distance may be more. So what happens? The diffusion, whatever is occurring in our body, the exchange of gases, what is occurring in our body, that is not sufficient in the plant for transportation system. So what is not sufficient? Diffusion. So diffusion not sufficient. Because each and every cell, the diffusion should take place. If the distance between the soil and the chlorophyll means, if the plant becomes taller, the distance increases. So diffusion is not sufficient. And along with this, energy is very important. I told you, because for so many activities we need energy. So plant also requires energy. Okay, so whatever the energy is required by the plant, what happens? The photosynthesis during that time, whatever food is produced, that food is stored into the chlorophyll, and whenever plant requires the energy, see what happened? that food will provide the energy to the plants. But whatever this energy which is provided to the plants, it is very important, because this energy needed by the plants is less. Why the energy needed by the plants is less? Because it does not do locomotion. Movement is not there. For locomotion you require energy. So movement is not there. So it requires less energy. As it requires less energy, so what happens? The transportation is slow. So there is a slow transport in plants. So what's the reason for the slow transportation? The energy which is required by the plants is very less, because it does not do the locomotion. Due to that, what happens? There is a slow transport. And this transportation, what is happening in the plant, is divided into two pathways. That is the strategy in the plant, because I told you the chlorophyll, that is from the chlorophyll to the soil, the raw material should be reached. And from the soil to the chlorophyll, the raw material should be reached. So what is happening? The diffusion is not sufficient because the distance increases. So the strategy for transportation in plants and the slow transport, there are two pathways for the transportation in plants. That is, one pathway is by the xylem. What is the xylem? Already 9th standard you have learned. That is, in the plants itself, conducting tissues are there, because we require the carbon dioxide. What we require? The food which is prepared in the leaf should enter to the roots, and from the roots, water, minerals and all these raw materials should reach to the leaf. So for that you require the tissue, and they are called as conducting tissue. So xylem, it is conducting tissue. What the xylem will do? The xylem work is, it transports water and minerals through root. From where? From root to the leaves. That is what xylem, conducting tissue. Another path is required. Only food production is not enough, because that food should reach to each and every part of the plant also. So another conducting tissue is there, which is called as phloem. It is also conducting tissue. So it is also conducting tissue. What it will do? It will transport food and other substances. From where? From the leaf to the root. So this is what the transportation in plants is there. But in detail we will study how the transportation of water takes place, and how the transportation of food and other, what you call it as, substances takes place. I explained you just now only that the transport of water and food, before that I told you there is a strategy in the plants, because diffusion is not sufficient. So what is happening over here is that strategy. What strategy is there? Conducting tissues are there in the plants. There are two different types of conducting tissue. One is the xylem and another is the phloem. So these conducting tissues, the roots are also having what? Tubular structure, which are called as tracheids. So the tracheids of the roots, the xylem, the phloem, the stem and the leaves, all these are interconnected in such a way that they make channels. Channels means what? Tube-like structures. So that the water, minerals, food and other substances can easily pass from root to the other parts of the plant and from the other parts of the plant to the root. That is what the transport of water and food. So what is important in this? The what is that? The conducting tissues of xylem, the conducting tissues of the phloem, the stem, the leaves and the roots. In the roots, tracheates are there. Tracheates means small, small tubes are there. The root hairs, they are the small, small tubes. So all these are interconnected with each other. They form a network which will create channels. Channels means what? Tube-like structure. How in our body blood vessels are important. Same way these channels are important to transport, because water is in the liquid form. So it should be transported, and the food from the water quality as the leaves should be transported to the stem also and to the water quality as a root also. So this is what transport of water and food it is. Now let us try to learn in detail. Soil, the roots of the plants, they are deep into the soil, that you know. And soil has, what it has? Soil has water and water quality as the nitrogen, phosphorus, all in salt form is there in the soil. Just now only I explained you, carbon dioxide is not only the one raw material. It requires nitrogen also, it requires phosphorus also, and it requires other minerals. So all the minerals are present in the soil. So what happens? The xylem, what it does, whatever the water part of the soil is there, the xylem comes in the contact, the roots which are there, the roots comes in the contact with the soil, and in the roots the xylem is there. So the root and the xylem are already in the contact. The root will absorb only the water and minerals. And I told you they are interconnected. So the root is connected with the xylem. So the water and minerals start flowing into the xylem. You can see the arrow mark I have shown. So how they start flowing into the xylem? And you know, as the tree becomes taller and it has to move against the gravitation force. So it is very important to make any solvent to move against gravitation force if it is difficult. So what happens? It moves through osmosis. What is osmosis? From the higher concentration to the lower concentration, what happens when the solvent moves? Ma'am, which is the higher concentration and which is the lower concentration? So what happens? Inside the root, salts are there, there is no water content, so water content is less. In the soil, water content is more, so concentration of water is more in the soil. So there is higher concentration, and inside the roots, the concentration of water is less. So from higher concentration to the low concentration through osmosis, what happens? The xylem starts taking the water along with minerals and it starts moving. Okay? As it starts moving, as it moves up, what happens? The height of the tree is also counted. It has to move to a long distance. So osmosis will help over there. Besides this, if it wants to reach to the top of the tree, at the end point of the tree, then you have the capillary action. Capillary action means what? The capillaries you saw in the human circulatory system, they are small, very narrow tubules. So what happens? As the channels moves from root towards the top of the tree, what happens? The channels becomes very, very narrow. Narrow the channels, what will happen? The rise of the water will become very easy. So that is what is called as capillary action. So at the top of the tree, what will be there? Capillary action will be there. So osmosis and capillary action, both will help the water and minerals to rise from the root of the plant to stem, leaves and other parts of the plant. And I told you water is also very essential for the leaves also. Then what happens over here? Third thing also helps for the water to enter into the xylem. Now, leaves, I told you, under the leaves there are small pores. What are the pores called as stomata? So what happens? Through these pores, the water starts evaporating. The excess of water which is collected in the leaf, it is not needed that much water. That water should be thrown out. So it is thrown out by the form of evaporation. Through that pores, the water starts evaporating, which that is called transpiration. So what will happen when the transpiration is done? Again, what happens? The pressure is created. So due to that pressure, what happens? The water again from the roots rises up and reaches to the different parts of the plant. So what happens? So first, what it is there? Osmosis will help to reach the end point of the tree. What capillary action will help? And next one is what? Due to transpiration also, what happens? The pressure is created in the xylem, and due to that pressure, what happens? The xylem takes the water from the roots and it starts transporting. This is how the transport of water takes place in the plants. Once again, I will explain you. Carbon dioxide and energy is needed. It is stored in a chlorophyll. Not only carbon dioxide, the raw material is needed. It requires nitrogen, it requires phosphorus and other minerals. That should also enter into the plants for the plant bodies to develop, to build the plant bodies. So, what happens over here? Diffusion is not sufficient for the transportation. Why? Because as the height of the tree increases, the taller the tree, there is more distance between the soil and the chlorophyll, that is the leaves, to reach. So that long distance diffusion cannot take place. So diffusion is not sufficient. So for that, what happens? Another pathway is there, that is two pathways are done. What are the two pathways? One is the xylem and another is the phloem. Both are conducting tissues. Conducting tissues means what? They are tube-like structure in which the solvent or the solvent can flow very easily. So xylem is a conducting tissue, phloem is a conducting tissue. Xylem, phloem, the root hairs which are called the tracheas, then the stem and the leaves. In them also, what are they? Other types of tubes are there. They all these together will connect and they form a channels, that is tube-like structure, internet or the network. So what happens? The water and the food and other substance can easily, what happens? Transport can take place. The water can, transportation can take place from xylem to the leaf and to the other parts of the plants. Xylem, what happens is that it first, when it takes the water from the roots, the osmosis takes place. Why? Because in the soil, the water content is more. So, concentration of water in the soil is more. Inside the root, the water content is less. So, there is a lower region. So, what happens? Osmosis from the higher concentration to the lower concentration, what happens? The water flows. So, from the soil, the water enters into the root, and from the root, the xylem will take it up. Besides this, what happens? It has to reach to the top of the, that is the tip of the tree. Height is more, the tip will also will be, it has to travel a long distance. So for that purpose, what happens? The capillaries are there. It's further, the xylem, phloem and I told you, network is formed. As it moves up towards the tip, the network becomes thinner and thinner and thinner. So they convert themselves into capillaries. In the capillaries, the flow will be easy, so it will reach. Even the transpiration which is taking place in the leaf. What is transpiration? The leaves, okay, what happened? Extra water is there in the leaf which is not needed by the leaf. That extra water should be thrown out. And it is thrown out through the stomata. I told you, stomata is there below the leaves. So that is called as evaporation, and that process is called as transpiration. So what happens? Pressure is created because water, what happened? Amount of water became less. So due to that pressure, again from the xylem, the water starts rising. So this is transport of water. Next, let us see what is the transport of food. Food means what? The food which is prepared by the leaves. Here you can see food is made in the leaves. Water and minerals reaches to the leaf. The water and minerals, carbon dioxide, then your sunlight, then the chlorophyll, everything is needed for the process of photosynthesis, which is called food made. This food made, the leaf cannot keep for itself. Some of the food is stored in the chlorophyll, but other what you call food substances should be passed to the other parts of the plant, because the building of plant bodies is very important. Other parts also should grow. It requires food for growth. We also, our body also requires one food for growth. So what happens? The phloem, which also have formed a network. So what it does? The phloem, okay, through the phloem, the food substances and what? The food substances and other substances get transported from the leaves to the other parts of the what? Other parts of the plant. For that, it requires energy. Energy means what? It requires ATP. ATP is a form of energy. And I told you, energy only will get when food gets oxidized. So in the leaves, the food gets oxidized. So energy is produced, and that energy will make the it will help the phloem to conduct or to transport the food. Along with that, what happens? The phloem will exert pressure on the xylem also. So through the xylem also, the water start entering, because water and minerals continuously, the flow of water and minerals should reach the leaf, and continuously the food should be made, and that food should be transported to the other parts of the body. So for this continuity, xylem and phloem play important role. That is what happens. The transport of water and food takes place in the plant. So you have to remember this diagram. Okay, see what happens in transport of water and food. So you came to know. Let us see an experiment of evaporation. What is the experiment of evaporation tells us that what we have to do in this experiment, we have to take two pots of the same size. So first pot, same size. Second thing, you have to fill the pot with the soil. So soil, what it should be? Same amount. So what you have to fill? Same amount of soil should be filled in both the pots. Okay, then in first, this is, let us take, this is pot number one. Let us take this as pot number two. In pot one, you, what you are going to do, you are going to take a plant and you are going to keep that plant in this pot number one, having leaves in that plant. And what is the height of the plant is there? Same height in the pot number two, you are going to take the stick. So, plant in pot one, stick in pot two, height of these two is what? Same. So came to know. Then what we are going to do then, both this pot, that is the plant and the stick, we are going to cover it with plastic sheet. So cover. What are we going to do? Cover with plastic sheet. Both, that is the plant and the stick, both we are going to cover it with a plastic sheet. And one more thing also we are going to do. We are going to cover the pot also with the plastic sheet. So we are going to cover the pot also with a plastic sheet. So here also I am going to take and cover the pot also with the plastic sheet. Okay. Then I am going to keep these two pot in the sun. So what happens? What is the reason for covering the pot with the soil with the plastic piece? Whatever the water content in the soil is there should not be evaporated. So for that reason, we are going to cover the pot with the plastic sheet. Keep it in the sun. After 3 to 4 hours, you observe what happens in pot number one, where you have put the plastic cover and where the plant is inside the plastic cover, you will find droplets of water are there. In the pot number two, where stick is there, there are no droplets of water. Okay. What has happened over here? The photosynthesis also have taken place, and along with the photosynthesis, whatever the water from the soil through the xylem entered into the leaf, is some extra water which was there in the leaf, it will get evaporated through the stomata. And what we have done, we have tied a plastic so that water vapor what is coming out from the stomata in the form of droplets, it starts collecting inside the plastic sheet. So this shows that evaporation takes place in the plant. Let us see the stick. Stick is not a plant. In the stick, what we will find out, there is no evaporation in the stick. So what does it shows? That plant, there is a leaf performs the evaporation. So which part of the plant performs the evaporation? The leaf performs the evaporation. So this is regarding the experiment.